When does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes? Or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness?
Hey, young fella. All by yourself?
Yes, just me.
Greetings, everyone. Jay the Filthy Casual here with another episode of the Content Creators. Yes. Yes, Mr. Lee. We are alone. We are alone because we are just lowly little creators of our own little worlds. Not much like yourself. I mean, you created this vast, vast world, complete with all these, like, individual broken characters. Like Spider-Man, not wealthy, doesn't come from anything really, lives with his aunt, his parents are dead, he's an orphan.
They're the greatest stories ever told. Heroes show us we don't need to be perfect to do what's right. It's not about living without fear, but facing injustice. It's not about being powerful, but finding your calling when you least expect it. They show us it's okay to be vulnerable, no matter how tough you are. Because even though they're heroes, they're still human.
This ad mostly because everything they say in it is true, and when I saw it for the first time I was deeply touched, because he's right. Superheroes are just humans. They're gifted, they have special abilities, some help and some don't. But that's the thing about us as creators, or as people in general. It's human nature to want to help people. To reach out, to touch a life, to help make changes. When I joined the Content Creators Group, it was my intention to help people and to learn. And it was all this combined effort to try and help each other, to elevate one another to a whole new level. Because we all know that if it wasn't going to happen, we would need to do it ourselves.
I cannot tell you how much I love my fans. They, sometimes at night I'm sitting here and I'm thinking, what's it all about, you know? And then I get a letter from a fan, or I read something, or I see something, or I remember something, and I realize it's so lucky to have fans who really care about you. And that's the reason I care so much about the fans, because they make me feel so great.
It's like, in his many years of wisdom, that he tried to touch everyone, to try and please everyone. Well, it wasn't really the case. It's just that the more immense his world became, the more people enjoyed it, the more he gained fans. And it's the same business we're in. We create this content to try and better things, to make things our own, and when we gain the fans, it means so much to us. I remember when Kevin became my first follower and then my first Patreon, and he even went as far as to send me something. He sent me 2 signed lands in a letter, which I have framed on my wall. It's this kind of community that we try and become. To be not only fans, but friends.
Oh, man. I am so fired.
The nice thing about Stan Lee's universe is the fact that he was able to immerse himself. Now, in the earlier days of Marvel, he did a couple of cameos here and there, but it wasn't every movie. And then he slowly became a cameo king, kind of like, oh, Bruce. Bruce Campbell even was in the Spider-Man trilogy, the original one. Like, that's the nice thing about this. He loved it. He created this world for everyone, and I know recently that he has passed, and that's why I'm doing this honorary creators episode, which is a little too late, but in the end, when you're a fan, he's never really gone. He's always going to be there in the pages of Marvel, in the characters themselves. Because those characters were an extension of him. They are him.
You know, I guess one person can make a difference. Enough said.
Exactly. And I think that if he was to pass on any information or any tips, it would be to never take no for an answer. Be yourself and do your own thing. Because these are pretty much the words he lived by. And if it wasn't those words, Spider-Man may never have been published. He may have never gone out on his own to create this immersive universe. And it's the dedication and the time, all the work and effort of multiple different people to help bring this universe alive. Even up until the Netflix series, like, it's so immersive. I would have to say my favorite was Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. season 1-3, and then Peggy Carter. Mostly because the Marvel Cinematic Universe got tied into a TV universe, so it was, if you wanted to take that extra step, you could. You could sit at home and see what was happening in the background behind all the cinematic movies. Like the cleanup in the United Kingdom after Thor destroyed it with the Dark Elves. Like, it's so immersive and so deep. It's like you get sucked in and it becomes a part of you. You see inspiration everywhere and you see all this fun and all the creativeness that comes from it. It's inspirational. So this one is for you, Stan Lee. From one fan. From one fan, one friend.
Fellas, hey wait, where are you going? Hey, you were supposed to be my lift home. How will I get out of here? Hey, I've got so many more stories to tell. Guys, Excelsior.
I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Roundtable, and member of the Phoenix Syndicate. Thank you for watching. If you like this video and would like to see more like it, click the like button and subscribe. To be notified, don't forget the bell, because we all know YouTube won't do it. If you would like to support the cause further, you can donate at the links below. And I would like to thank the current supporters, because without you, this wouldn't be possible. And remember to support your local game store, as they are in the brick and mortar of the games community. I'm Jay the Filthy Casual, and thanks for stopping by.